that I don't really know how to go for the go for the first kiss.
That's actually a good thing you said, because that's actually is a problem that I also hear from a lot of guys. A lot of guys, they're like, oh, you know, should we go on the kiss? You know, should we go for the kiss the same day we meet her? How long should we wait for it? Mm. Or you know, stuff like that. Here are the basic rules. So we teach the whole sexual escalation model. I cannot explain you the whole model right now, but you know, so you meet a girl, you start touching her, and you keep escalating it. As your interaction is going on, you have to start getting more sexual with your touches. And if you, there comes a point where you start touching her sexually, it could be like touching her on the small of her back, it could be just rubbing her back, it could be playing with her hair, making strong eye contact while doing this is also important. If you've done these four or five things on consistently, and she hasn't objected to it, or she's reciprocating to it, then it's a good sign. That's when you know that you can go for the kiss. So this will all depend, this can happen in 5 minutes, this can take 1 hour, this can take 1 day. It all depends how soon you can get comfortable. Now, if you already have studied our sexual escalation model, you'll be doing it way faster, you know, then there is no guesswork, all the guesswork is eliminated. But as a general rule, hold her hand, squeeze her hand, see if she squeezes it back. If she squeezes your hand back, it's a good sign. Even if she does not squeeze it back, it's still a good sign as long as she does not pull it away, okay? Play with her hair. If she lets you play, it's a good sign. Rub her back. If she lets you rub, it's a good sign. You know, just brush her arms. And if she does not object to it, it's a good sign. So if you've done these three, four things, that means she's totally going to be okay with the kiss. And at that point, you know, just, there are three ways we usually go for the kiss. And at that point, you can, this is like the cheesiest method that I used to do to test the waters. I would go peck on the left cheek, peck on the right cheek, and quick peck on the lip. So I'll be like, kiss, kiss, kiss. And you know, that was just to get her used to the idea of kissing. And if she accepts that, or if she doesn't object to that, then I know I can go for a better makeout pretty soon, because now I've already given her the idea that I want to get sexual with her. Mm-hmm. The second way is, you know, if the girl's right here, I'm going to get close to her, and I'll start like, you smell really good, I'll almost start smelling her, and then slowly I'll turn my face towards her, so I'll be like, smell really good, and then I'll gradually move forward to go for the kiss. Here's the thing, I will not move back, I will not pull my head back, and I'm not going to rush in. And the third thing is you can just hold her hand and pull them down, not towards you, pull them down. Anytime you pull the hands down, so if the hands are pulled down, you automatically lean in. Yeah. So it doesn't feel like you're pulling them in. Just pull it gently down, they're going to lean in, and then you slowly keep going in while looking into their eyes. It's very powerful.
It's like a judo move.
Yeah, and it's very powerful. And women love that. Women love the slow motion. That's also the sign of a confident guy, that you're not trying to trick her, you're giving her all the time and the opportunity if she wants to say no. So I'm just going to pull you in slowly, and I'm going to come in slowly, as opposed to let's go and kiss. No, you take your time, you have all the time to say no, but I know this is going to happen because you like me and I like you. And once in a while, this will happen that you will go for the kiss and the girl will just turn around and, you know, she's not ready for the kiss. She'll just give you her cheek, or she's like, oh, I'm not ready for it, or something like that. As long as she does not say don't do it again, it's okay. It's a good sign. If a woman does not like that you're going for the kiss, she will walk away. So as long as she does not walk away, it's a good sign. It just means she didn't see the kiss coming. I call it a shock factor. She was not prepared for the kiss. So go back to touching her again, do the same three or four touches that I said again. If she does not object to it again, this time you can go for the kiss again. And it will definitely happen this time. Because first time, maybe she didn't recognize what was happening, but you've gone for the kiss, you go back and squeeze her hand again, brush her arms, you know, rub her back. She has to be the biggest retired woman on this planet to not know what you're trying to do again, especially after you've gone for the kiss. Yeah. So you do that and it's going to happen.